KBL has just nominated Bongbong Marcos as their standard bearer for the 2022 presidential elections. How is this going to affect the process? What do you think will be the impact of this on your selection process?
Well, ang sa akin, yung sa pagtakbo ni Bongbong Marcos, that is a, to me, good news as far as the opposition and democratic forces are concerned. If you look at it, the 16 million votes of Duterte included Bongbong Marcos votes from the north. So, sa akin, that is also an additional fragmentation of the Duterte votes in addition to the, sabi nga natin, na fragment na dahil yung kanyang loyalist na si Alan Peter Cayetano, number one DDS, umalis na kay President Duterte. Si Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez at yung iba pang niyang grupo, umalis na rin kay President Duterte. And if Pacquiao even runs, mai-split din niya yung boto ng Mindanao. So we look at this as former votes of President Duterte when he ran in 2016. And it shows that these votes are no longer solid for President Duterte or Sara or whoever his anointed will be because nag-fragment na sila, naghati-hati na sila. And that's why it is more evident or more impairment for the opposition to unite para sa amin, we are solid against whoever the candidate or candidates of the Duterte administration will be.
But are you going to be eventually the representation of the true opposition? Because that's the fear, that as you continuously search to unify the opposition, that it may not be the true opposition eventually. What is your answer to that?
Well, you know, yeah, you know, Carmina, the true opposition is subjective, no? What we are looking forward to is a leader that will respect the Constitution, a leader that will respect the sovereign rights of the Philippines, a leader that will take us out from the pandemic, take us out from this economic slump, a leader that will respect civil liberties, civil rights, even domestic and international accountability, not only of corruption, but also of justice and the EJK. So, dun po, patungo tayo. We do not like to brand people as Dilawan or DDS or KBL or whatever, or loyalist or whatever. We look at everybody as Filipinos, kaya nga isang bayan. So we look at them as where they stand and how do we bring and move forward the Philippines from 2022.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Attorney Howard Calieja there, convener of Opposition Coalition Isang Bayan. Thank you, Howie, for joining us today.
Thank you, Carmina, and good afternoon to everybody. Salamat po.